Let's talk about it. By now, I'm sure you've heard Silicon Valley Bank has closed its doors. Why did this happen? What is it going to mean for the housing market? Let me preface this by saying I am not a financial expert and not a financial advisor. Do not take this as financial advice. This is informational purposes only. SVB is a niche bank. Its clients were predominantly in the tech industry, startup companies like Etsy, Shopify, and SVB took the deposits from its clients and invested it like all banks do. It invests billions of dollars in treasury bonds. That would have been fine if the economy was okay and the treasury bonds were allowed to mature and then a positive return on that investment was going to be realized. But the Fed started increasing interest rates at a very quick pace, which caused those bond values to go down. In order to keep their operations going, SVB had to sell off a large portion of that investment early at a loss. When their clients got word of this, they started to get nervous and started pulling their money out of SVB. When word of that got out, panic ensued and a run on the bank happened, and they had to close their doors because literally they ran out of money. The good news is the FDIC is going to insure individual depositors up to $250,000 of their money. Unfortunately, 97% plus of the clients that SVB has had more than $250,000 deposited in that institution. So we're gonna have to just wait and see how that all plays out. The bad news is the stock investors and bondholders of SVB are wiped out. What does this mean for the housing market? It's nothing like the crash of 2008. That crash happened because banks were investing in subprime mortgage loans that were being handed out to anybody with a pulse at that time. This is nothing like that. This is a niche bank with a specific area of business, and they invested most of, if not all of their eggs in one basket. Their clients have put all of their eggs in SVB's basket. On the plus side, according to one of the national lenders that I work with, who's also a certified banker, the takeaway is the Fed is likely going to have to, if not slow down the rate of increase of interest rates, but cut them back. We're probably going to be looking at lower mortgage rates for home buyers. If you have any questions at all about buying or selling real estate, reach out to me. I'll give you whatever information you need so that you can make an informed decision and you can decide what is best for you to do, whether that is sell your home, stay in your home, purchase a new home, or if you feel like moving your money out of certain investments and putting it into real estate is the best move for you, I'm here for you.